Lava and welcome to Tagata Pasifika. This week we continue our summer series about outstanding people in our community. Eleitino Paddy Walker was the founding president of the now famous women's organisation Pacifica.
We take a look back at Paddy's many achievements and the history of the Pacifica organisation.
Pacifica, it's a name that's now become iconic to Pacific Islanders in New Zealand. The legendary women's group that's seen so many successful women shine in its ranks, nurtured, encouraged and supported on the shoulders of those who were amongst the first Pacific migrants to this country.
You know the island people. Usually the main folk, our job is at the back. We learn and keep quiet at the back. But now I see the change.
I feel there's so much here that these women who belong to Pacifica, they get together, they can move mountains for the benefit of all.
In those days, we needed a place where us Pacific Island women can feel that we can get up and spout forth about how we can do better than what we are getting. And it's held us, you know, the faithful, together for that long. And I think the passion is still in there, although the legs may not be strong, but the will is there to do it.
At this point, I'd like to ask Paddy Walker to open our evening in prayer.
Dear Father,
the founding face behind this organisation, so significant to many Pacific people, was an unlikely one at the time. She has the title Eleitino today, but in those days she was Paddy Walker, a Remuera socialite known in the tourism and fashion circuits, worlds away from the breadlines of brown Auckland in the 60s and 70s.
You know the day destroys the night, night divides the day, try to run.
My reason for being in this world, I think, was had a huge amount to do with my Samoanness, because it's always been present in whatever I've done in my life and the various changes in my life. And in fact, being Samoan was the reason for the biggest change in my life, which was to move from the world of fashion at the end of the 69s when Mr. Muldoon opened the gates to Pacific Island people to come in to become labour, and I realised that there was very little I understood about social issues. New Zealand had no preparation for the people it had invited in, and Samoa itself had no preparation. I remember ringing in desperation one day, ringing for Toi Mata'afa, who is to me an icon of Pacific women, and saying, Fatoi, the people are arriving and they haven't even got the right clothes on, they're lighting fires on the oven, they don't know how to turn on the electricity, they're stuffing up the lavatories, everything is, they're so unprepared for being here. She said, Paddy, why should we prepare people to go away? Which I thought was extremely sensible. I'd never even thought about that. But I realised that New Zealand's need was being met by Samoa's need, Tonga's need, which was to help the economy. Then I knew what I was to do, which was to bring women together. I'd been working with women all my life, and I felt it just came, was rather like an inspiration. And I had already developed a council of Samoan women, so I had them to call upon. I'd already made friends with Niuean women, and I had quite a few relations as well, who all rose to the occasion, or most rose to the occasion. Some said, what do you think Paddy's doing? She doesn't know anything about Samoan people. Though she's lived a different kind of life, had the opportunity to be well-educated. In other words, a kind of disdain for the fact that I was trying to do these things. Anyway, didn't matter. The next thing is we called a meeting, and everybody wanted to help. People led the YWCA. Everybody wanted to be involved. People cared, but just needed somebody to pull them together. It was necessary to bring us together to speak with one voice, because nobody was going to listen to us one by one. And in speaking together, we're going to be heard, and we're going to change life for Pacific Island people so that they move into the total society. In the end, that was the whole dream, to create the opportunity for Pacific Island women to move into the total society.
It's a very powerful group, and I'm aware that from some quarters that it has been described as a group of elitist women. That's not necessarily a bad thing insofar as I'm concerned, because it does demonstrate that the women who have the expertise in terms of New Zealand society have come together to assist others who have not quite that expertise, but who have cultural expertise.
Pacifica was the binding force through which many Pacific women launched themselves into the wider world. Many migrant island women were lacking in language skills and confidence to widen their education or employment horizons, being mothers of large families or working multiple jobs. Pacifica also became an important social network for those experiencing urban isolation.
The fact that so many women were alone, you know, they were doing things alone, and we are not that kind of people. We like to do things together, we like to be with other people, and somehow it gives us a kind of strength.
But while socialising, it's bringing Pacific Island women together, Tongan, Samoan, Cook Island women, who are different in so many ways. The languages are different, therefore the communication language has to be English. So many of the larger community, so much of the larger community lumps us all under one umbrella, Pacific Islanders. They're all the same, you know, but they're not.
There is a very real feeling for an island person that she is an island person living in New Zealand, but she doesn't feel like a New Zealander. And when Pacifica came into being, its greatest feeling was that we give a sense of belonging to this country.
We are a very different organisation of women. Pacifica is not just an organisation of women, it's an organisation of families.
Woman in New Zealand, Paddy Walker was an early example of someone who had stood up to be a voice on mainstream boards and is the first female Pacific Auckland City Councillor. She was a driving force behind getting other Pacific women into similar decision-making roles in the wider community.
I saw for Pacific Island women their totally different needs. Their needs in this new country, and that of course is important, because the needs of Pacific Island women in their own country is quite different to their needs here. I saw and understood very well that in this new land, they were almost lost in the feeling that they were the mother, the wife, the hard worker in the family, but they really had not very great role in the society of New Zealand. And I think if there was anything important, it seemed to me that they needed to be able to see that there was a very clear role, a definite role, an important role, that they could make a difference to the attitudes in New Zealand society towards Pacific Island people.
She encouraged everybody, she encouraged all the women that if we go into these places and nobody would nominate us, just get up and nominate yourself.
We had new women in our council, and I tried to urge Rangi Veliko to stand for the Parent Teachers Association at Ngā Tapuai. This is 30 years ago, over 30 years ago. Oh, she said, Paddy, I only went to standard three. She said, I can't go in. I can't talk to the people. Yes, I said, Rangi, you can. She said, what do I do? I said, well, you go in to the meeting and you get another Polynesian, you take one with you to nominate you. And then I'm sure you'll find that people will all vote for you because it's really necessary that Pacific Island people are now on community service, parent teachers association, city councils, whenever possible. So at 9 o'clock that night, phone went, I knew it was Rangi. And Rangi said, oi, Paddy. Yes, Rangi. She said, well, I went to the meeting. There was no Polynesians there. Oh, my heart dropped, you know. No Polynesians there. So I nominated myself. And I'm in. Isn't that a beautiful story? That's courage.
By the 1980s, more Pacific women were becoming politically involved and very clear about what directions they wanted to take in areas like late life education and employment options.
I think it gave them motivation to get into the different organisations that are within their own communities.
I never dreamed that I'll reach this achievement. But as our old people say, the prayers go well with work, you'll get somewhere.
You just have to discipline yourself and say that I am going in there and fight for my people.
The issues for the Pacifica group have changed radically since Paddy's founding days in the 1970s. Social change has brought new challenges for the group to recognise and to address.
Been repeatedly beaten with a belt, and you can see there the whip marks up and down his back. And some people would say this is appropriate discipline.
At one stage, a lot of things were very embarrassing to talk about. But the women, through those education programs, are able to listen and understand that, yes, there are problems out there, and to take some responsibility about fixing those up.
Finding a job is very hard. As you know, the pay equity is a problem, a big issue out here in New Zealand. We're talking about Pacific Island women and Māori. They are mainly at the low-paid work that where they are currently at. So when we first came in, we all started off picking fruits at farms, but now they have moved from that to being cleaners, but now they are more well-established or moving into the trend now is into the aged care sector.
I think it's important for any woman who rises to the top to be aware of whose shoulders she stands on, right? So whether it's women who have worked in the service industry in this country and have organized in unions, or whether it's, you know, women who have helped, you know, the work that Pacifica has done to help immigrant women settle in, you know, even if it's a Te Vai Vai collective, you know, all of that collective work allows younger women to rise to the top.
And today there are many Pacific women achieving more than ever before, manifesting those early dreams of the original Pacifica Committee.
If you think there's nothing you can do to support me as a judge, you are so wrong. I cannot do what I am about to set out to do if I don't have hope for young people and the families of this country. You can give me that hope.
Our women could have been in Parliament a long time ago, but perhaps there wasn't the access or the encouragement. I felt there was a need for us to get into those hard areas.
Before, we were trying to bring Pacific Island women into the total society. What's happened now is those Pacific Island women are giving to New Zealand. We're no longer, I don't think, in the position of trying to find our way. We know our way.
60% of the population here in New Zealand born Pacific, and a large percentage of those are women. And so it requires now a new style of leadership that addresses the needs of the new 21st century, and it's dynamic.
to say thank you to Pacifica and to Pacific women, because I think if you reflect back 30 years, who would have envisaged where we are today? And I pay tribute to the women who came to New Zealand as the first generation migrants, held the family's hand in a new land, really emphasised the importance of education and being good and hard-working citizens, and look where it has brought these communities. I think it's a time to celebrate and be very positive.
Eleitino Paddy Walker's legacy to the Pacific Island community in founding Pacifica has seen it grow from strength to strength. There are scholarships and health initiatives, annual workshops and seminars, and Pacifica's kept alive in its modern-day incarnation with the new generations.
It's better than staying, like, listening in to the old people and stuff.
I think something like this, a workshop, especially a dance workshop, urban dance, is something that would attract the young ones, the youth. It's something that the youth are really into at the moment.
I think it's really important for young people to grow in Pacifica, to learn what our mothers before us and grandmothers who have built this in New Zealand, this organisation, to just continue with its legacy.
We've made a whole lot of the advances, I think, that our mothers and their mothers strived for. In this age, what we try to do in Auckland is find out what is the relevance of Pacifica to the young generations coming through.
Eleitino was honoured in a special ceremony this year. Women from all over the country gathered in Auckland to pay tribute to this well-known matriarch of Pacifica, still actively a part of the organisation at age 90.
The contribution has been enormous, probably immeasurable, because it's from those humble beginnings that we now have this organisation, which we love, and we hope to keep going for the next 30 years.
We were colourful, we were musical, we all danced, and the memory was, for us, home.
A Pacific woman is a Pacific woman, that I know where I came from. It's my identity. And to actually have all the women around, it makes you feel stronger.
Paddy set the example, and she gave the women courage to be heard, and that whatever they put their mind to, they could manage it, because there's a whole lot of other people behind them to support them.
The Pacific Island Youth Leadership Trust is a body which awards scholarships to promising Pacific Island students. This year's award ceremony was held at Auckland Girls Grammar School.
Another milestone in the Pacific community credited to Eleitino was the Pacific Youth Leadership Trust Scholarship, establishing financial aid to hundreds of Pacific students around the country.
I felt real good about myself, and it boosted my self-esteem, and just knowing that people out there, there are people there that care about what you're doing, and that they want to help you achieve your goals.
Saved me from seeking extra finance for those textbooks and the computer, and it encouraged me to do well. The incentives to get the other half of the scholarship, as you know, later on in the year.
Paddy's baby in education was the Pacific Island Youth Leadership Trust. And Paddy was the one that went cap in hand to people like Sir Don Meyer, people like Hugh Fletcher, lots of business people in Auckland who had connections with Pacific people, and was able to get a lot of money to for us to offer scholarships to very many young people from around about 1983 on to the late 90s.
The whole purpose of coming together, developing Pacific Island Youth Leadership Trust was to develop scholarships for students to go to university. And we were very successful with this, very much helped by people like Douglas Myers, Alan Gibbs, Hugh Fletcher, all would support 20 at a time. And you've no idea, the most wonderful feeling in the world is when somebody comes up to you and says, "Oh, you helped me to become a lawyer." Just makes me want to cry.
Paddy's work as an educator has seen her develop many different initiatives in schools, in the arts arena, and now in her autumn years in music. This year, at her adopted late life home in the Cook Islands, she launched a CD of different compositions called Pacific Peace Images in Music.
There's a tremendous need, and that is actually why I've developed this music. There is a tremendous need in the world to introduce song, dance, mime, movement, and drama to the school curriculum. Having a purpose in life, I think, is the most important thing I can say. I think being without a purpose leaves you without any sense of being useful. And I think it's absolutely necessary for us to have a sense of value. We have a sense that we are worth something, we've got something to give. I would say I've learnt something from everything. I think my whole life I've been very fortunate. I haven't the opportunity to grow. I remember somebody once ringing and saying, I rang because somebody said you had retired. And I said, "Well, what does that mean?" "Well, that you've stopped work." "No," I said, "I'm still growing."
Some moments from Eleitino Paddy Walker over the years. Next week, we continue our usual Tagata Pasifika program as our summer profile series has come to an end.
Now, remember, you can watch this program online at any of these websites on the bottom of your screen. Until next week, I bid you farewell. Ni samore.
Tō whāsoi fō, everyone.
Pacifica, wanna be proud, people of the sun. This program was made with funding from New Zealand On Air.